Good morning. I'm Assistant Sheriff Charles Hank, and I'm going to brief you on additional details as we know them today about the officer-involved shooting that occurred on Wednesday, March 27, 2019. This is officer-involved shooting number 7, non-fatal number 5. Same time last year, we were at officer-involved shooting number 3, non-fatal number 2. The date and time of the call was March 27, 2019 at 8:53 a.m., and it started out as an assistant officer call. The location of the officer-involved shooting is 2950 South Maryland Parkway, located in the Southeast Area Command. The time of the shooting with shots fired was approximately 8:53 a.m. The involved officer is Officer Phong Nguyen, and I'll spell his name, P-H-O-N-G, that's the first name, last name Nguyen, N-G-U-Y-E-N. He is 25 years old and has been with the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department since October 2016. In this incident, Officer Nguyen was armed with a Glock 17 9mm handgun equipped with a tactical light. The investigation revealed he fired 3 rounds during this incident. Officer Nguyen was not wearing a body-worn camera during this incident. The suspect is Gregory Joseph Ganci. He is a 52-year-old white male adult, 6'1", 300 pounds. The vehicle Ganci stole was a 2016 Chevy Silverado 2500 crew cab. Excuse me. Ganci's criminal history was a 4-time convicted felon for in 2008, he was a fugitive parole violation out of California. 2016, out of Illinois, he had arrest for fugitive from another state on complaint and warrant. In April of 2018, his Nevada convictions are robbery with deadly weapon, conspiracy to commit robbery, battery with deadly weapon, firearm, kidnap first degree, conspiracy to commit kidnap, assault with deadly weapon 2 counts, carry concealed weapon firearm, and prohibited person in possession of a firearm. On March 8, 2019, he was also convicted of prevent, dissuade person from testifying, bribe, intimidate a witness to influence testimony, conspiracy to prevent, dissuade a person from testifying, and conspiracy to commit non-felony crime. As all of you are aware, yesterday, March 28, Ganci was sentenced to 5 consecutive life sentences without the possibility of parole for the crimes he was being held for at the Clark County Detention Center. Ganci's new charges as a result of his escape attempt was escape by prisoner, grand larceny auto, battery with deadly weapon 2 counts, and felony evading police. The details of the officer-involved shooting. On Wednesday, March 27, 2019, Officer Nguyen took Clark County Detention Center inmate Gregory Ganci to the Steinberg Diagnostics Center for a medical procedure. At the completion of the procedure, Ganci was being escorted by Officer Nguyen through the parking lot towards Nguyen's unmarked patrol vehicle. As Nguyen and Ganci were walking, a Chevy crew cab pickup truck stopped in the parking lot with the engine running and the driver's door left open. The truck belonged to a man who provides auto detailing to some of the staff at the medical facility. The driver of the vehicle had stepped out of the truck to retrieve something in the rear of the truck bed. His passenger also had gotten out of the truck to go inside the building. At this time, Ganci, who was in belly chains and leg shackles, saw the unoccupied truck, jumped into the driver's seat, and took off through the parking lot. As the truck sped through the parking lot, Officer Nguyen fired 3 rounds at Ganci, striking the driver's side window and door. Ganci was struck once in the left tricep. Ganci continued driving through the parking lot and then turned northbound on Maryland Parkway. As Ganci drove north on Maryland Parkway, traffic was stopped at Vegas Valley due to a red light. Ganci drove into the left lanes of the northbound Maryland Parkway, passing an LVMPD prisoner transport van, also stopped at the light. Ganci came up behind a black Nissan sedan that was stopped in traffic and slammed into the car. He then put the pickup in reverse and rammed the Nissan several times, forcing his way through the traffic, damaging four cars. By then, Officer Nguyen was in his unmarked patrol car and began pursuing Ganci with lights and sirens. Marked patrol units from the downtown area command, as well as the Northeast Area Command, joined the pursuit until Ganci's vehicle ran out of gas near Main Street and Carson, where he was taken into custody. Arresting officers provided Ganci with emergency medical attention and called for the ambulance. He was taken to UMC Trauma and treated for the gunshot wound. Ganci was released from the hospital and rebooked into the Clark County Detention Center. We do not have body-worn camera video from the shooting. However, we will show you video obtained through our investigation. You see the vehicle pulling out right there, and you just heard shots being fired.
Oh my gosh.
This is from a business just to the east of the intersection. You see his vehicle here at the top left, ramming the vehicles in front of him. Let's play that first video one more time, Jeff. You hear the three shots being fired.
Oh my gosh.
And now the vehicle's pulling out. And just for information, that other prisoner transport vehicle, those were two officers that were transporting another inmate to the same facility. At this time, I'll answer any questions you may have.
What happened with Nguyen's body camera?
He did not have a body camera with him at this time.
Will there be a review on how inmates are supervised for medical procedures?
Absolutely. Yes, sir.
What are you all going to be looking at?
Well, we're looking at a variety of things. Of course, once we complete our investigation, we'll see what occurred in this incident. We're also making some adjustments to ensure that we have sufficient staff anytime we take someone out of the jail and to be taken to any type of medical facility for evaluation or procedure.
Maybe for just as a basis, what are the procedures now? You know, we're not really familiar with what those are when you're taking an inmate to for a procedure or whatever. What's the standard operating procedure?
Well, it depends on the care or the medical issue that the inmate is facing. Sometimes that inmate may be transported by ambulance or medical provider. We have to go to a variety of locations. UMC is not set up to evaluate every type of medical situation that an inmate has, so some of the requirements require us to go to facilities just like Steinberg. So right now, in looking at this incident, we've already taken steps, and moving forward, we're requiring two officers to be with any inmate that we're taking outside a facility.
So he was following protocol as far as this facility, as far as this prisoner, as far as this procedure that was going to be performed was concerned. He was doing everything correct.
Right. It was appropriate for the officer to take him to that facility with that officer and that inmate alone. That's correct, sir.
Why wasn't he wearing a body camera? Was he in plain clothes?
No, he was not in plain clothes. He was in uniform, and he should have had his body-worn camera with him.
Where did Ganci get his window of opportunity during this medical procedure that he was supposed to get?
That, in terms of window of opportunity to escape?
Yeah.
We're not clear on that right now. We have not got to that information. We will be interviewing the officer during our administrative process to review what occurred, and the officer will be required to explain to us what occurred and led up to this occurring.
Can you say what kind of medical procedure Ganci was going
to? I'm not sure exactly what that medical procedure was at this time. All right. Do you have another question?
With him running out of gas, that helped out, right? It could have been worse if he had not run out of gas.
Absolutely. It could have been worse. It, just for information, this citizen actually would have had a firearm within the vehicle. And the officers that were pursuing him were made aware of that. And thankfully, he did run out of gas because there was a firearm within that vehicle.
Do you know the exact mileage of
the with the pursuit? It was approximately 13 miles. Excuse me. It was about 13 minutes. I apologize. The exact distance, I'm not sure. He drove through a variety of streets. We could get that information for you, though. But I know the pursuit lasted about 13 minutes.
And then are corrections officers required to wear the cameras the same as, in the field metro patrol officers?
No. At this time, no. Our correction officers are not fitted with body-worn cameras. We do have some that we're in the process of outfitting with body-worn cameras, but at this time, our corrections staff typically do not wear body-worn cameras.
So it's possible that he, on a corrections detail, would not have worn the camera as a matter of course?
Right now, correction officers are not outfitted with body-worn cameras. And so that's where we are. Did you have one more question?
How disturbing is it to know that this guy was really dangerous? I mean, he's a four-time felon and fugitive. How disturbing is it to realize that this guy was pretty bad?
Well, obviously it's very disturbing, and we're grateful for the outcome as it occurred, that no members of our community were injured severely. Obviously ramming the car, that's of concern. But we're glad that anyone wasn't hurt very seriously from this incident. Thank you all.